How long have you been petitioning for women's rights here?
Since the 70s.
And what was it like in the 70s compared to today?
Well, today it's a lot worse.
So you think that the state of our socio-political climate right now in America in 2019 is worse than it was in 1970?
Yeah.
I think it's just bizarre that we're going to towards Gilead, which is in the book, is a dystopia. And it was written as a warning, not a manual.
And so what do women's rights mean to you exactly?
That women have control over their bodies, that they can make their own decisions about their own reproductive health.
Equal Rights Amendment, that's what it means.
The issue is about, are we citizens of the United States deserving equality? Or are we not? Does this body belong to me or doesn't it? And I believe that this body belongs to me and my daughter's body belongs to her.
We have our own rights. We have autonomy over our own bodies, that we do what we want to do with our own body. And I don't think that anybody without a vagina doesn't need to be making decisions about mine.
I think that men co-opting women's rights and women's bodies is completely wrong. We need to be equal and have a choice about what happens to our own bodies and how to take care of ourselves. And if we choose to have children, then we should be able to have the healthiest children possible and medical care available for us. And right now, we just have mostly white men in power who are making these rules.
Their rights are our rights as well. So if something's happening to them that's unfair, we should all be standing up.
What concrete things can people be doing day in and day out to fight against these laws?
Well, a couple of things that they can do. They can certainly follow the ACLU, ACLUGA.org. We have many, many platforms, Instagram, Facebook, and so forth, that will let people know what's going on, when we file, and so forth. And then the other thing that we will is to really talk to your friends and family about what an important issue this is, because ultimately we have to deal with this by electing members of the legislature who are going to defend women's rights and women's health and not attack it.
You know, the people have spoken. 70% of the American population thinks it's a woman's right to choose. I know, that's really hard to believe, but that's why I'm the real Donna J. Trump and not the Donald Trump. I'm his worst nightmare. I do what he can't do. I'm a woman. What do women do besides give birth? We bring people together, and that's what the real Donna J. Trump does.
My mom got pregnant when she was 17 with me. She's over there, actually. And when she first told me, I didn't know anything about it or what it entailed or anything. I was like 14 or 15. And then I educated myself and learned a lot. And now I'm here and we're both here. And I hope that if one day I do have a daughter that, you know, we can be here together.
And we will thrive the more we get the government out of our existence and learn to govern within our own brains and our own sovereignty.
Well, I think it's important for young people especially to understand that elections matter. Brian Kemp promised to pass a restrictive abortion bill, and that's what he did, and that's what he signed. People have got to register, they've got to vote, and they've got to vote for the kinds of policies that they want and the state that they want to live in.